What does the tape prove? Well, that's a matter of debate. Reasonably, you could say it proves that Cohen could not be trusted by Trump. But you can also say that now there's a legitimate question about whether or not you can trust the president when it comes to telling the truth. Is it okay that he was coordinating this type of payment, as is clear from the tape? Let's bring in great debaters, Anna Navarro and Steve Cortez. Good to see you both. Let's start with some sound. Here is Rudy Giuliani making his case of what this means for the president, and that will be butted up to actual dialogue between Trump and Cohen on the same point.
I agree with you. The tape is a little bit hard to hear, but I assure you that we listened to it numerous, numerous times. And the transcript makes it quite clear at the end that President Trump says, quote, don't pay with cash.
Listen, what financing?
We'll have to pay you some.
Don't pay with cash.
We'll have to pay you some.
Don't pay with cash.
Anna Navarro, what do you hear and why does it matter?
Chris, this reminded me so much of that debate earlier this year about Yanni or Laurel. Do you hear Yanni or do you hear Laurel? Some people definitely heard Yanni. Some people definitely heard Laurel. Look, if you are a defender of Donald Trump, you hear what you want to hear. If you are an opponent of Donald Trump, you clearly hear that he wants to pay cash to bury the story of this playmate, and you put the pieces together. In of itself, this tape doesn't prove anything except to prove that there are other tapes. This is just one piece in the very large puzzle that Bob Mueller is putting together. Look, Michael Cohen, if he recorded one tape, you better believe this is like cockroaches, man. Where there is one, there is more.
Oh, believe
there
me,
has gotta
I'm well
be
aware.
More tapes.
It's about the relevance on each one. Let's start with this one. It's Steve Cortez. Let me bump up Anna's vig on this. This tape does prove pretty reasonably that the president wasn't hearing about these efforts to get around the Karen McDougal payment for the first time. He knows the dollar amount involved. He's familiar with the construction. He's familiar with what Cohen is going to do. He has an opinion about how to do it. These are all elements that we were told by his campaign and by the White House he knew nothing about.
From what we heard of that tape, and by the way, that's a carefully edited part. It seems like it. It does. And by the way, I agree with Anna,
carefully
which
edited.
Almost never happens. Well, how do we know? We haven't heard the rest of it. We didn't hear what preceded it.
What else do you have to hear?
He knows.
He didn't say, what are you talking about? What corporation?
All of it. I'd like
Why
to
am
hear,
I doing this?
I'd like to hear. I'd like to hear all of it. But here's the thing. Listen, I agree with Anna. To me, when I hear it with my ears, it sounds like the president is talking about cash. But here's, by the way, too, talking about cash, it always reminds me, I think you and I, Chris, are roughly the same age. I just think of the Wu-Tang Clan and cash rules everything about me. That came out when I was in college. I never thought
Strong
I'd be talking
reference.
About presidential politics.
Strong reference. Steve Cortez, raised by Wu-Tang.
Never thought I'd be talking about it in presidential politics. But here's my point. Who cares? How does it matter? If they talked, okay, if that's correct, and if the president mentioned the then president-elect, or excuse me, candidate, mentioned cash, and it seems to me he did, so what? I mean, what does that change?
It changes, one, that he didn't know anything about this. Yes, he did know about it, and it shows that he was all in favor of figuring out how to keep this stuff quiet.
But
and that's a
Chris,
political
okay,
question,
really?
Not a legal one.
Hold
on, Steve.
Hold on.
Anna, what's
wrong?
Let's see what Anna says.
Is there actually anybody in America who believes or believed that Donald Trump did not know about this? Look, there's such a thing as people who don't want to believe the truth. But really, if you look at yourself in the mirror, you know the guy lied. You know he's a liar. He is a pathological liar. There is no room in newspapers to print all the lies that he says on a daily basis. So is it a surprise to anybody that he lied about an affair with a Playboy bunny after his wife had just given birth? Color me shocked.
Okay.
This is my face of shock that Donald Trump lied, which is why it doesn't have that much of a political significance. Now, could it have a legal significance? Hell yes. Just ask John Edwards. You know, but it depends what else there is.
Well, there was
puzzle.
No transaction, Anna, and that's going to be a big hole in the potential illegality argument. They never bought the assets back, as far as we know. So it's hard to say that this was a campaign finance
this
violation
time.
On this one. Stormy Daniels could be something else. Steve Cordes, you were making a little bit of a gas face there when Anna was saying everybody thinks he lied. You don't think he lied about Karen McDougal?
No. I don't know, and to be frank, that he didn't know anything about it until after it happened. Hold on.
Because that's what he
told me. To be frank, I don't care. I don't care.
That's a different question.
I really don't. I think it's totally irrelevant, and the American people told us it's irrelevant.
Truth is irrelevant?
Nobody voted. No, hold on. Nobody voted for Donald Trump believing that they were voting for a saint, believing that they were voting for John the Baptist, believing that in the 1980s and 90s and his past life as a mogul.
John the Baptist, saint, or all this crap that we're hearing about?
Nobody believed that. And because
they also didn't think they were voting for Hugh Hefner.
And no laws were broken. And by the way, here's the thing, too. Here's the flip side of that, though, too. And here's where it becomes really moral is this man has done nothing but protect religious liberty for America in both laws and Supreme Court nominees. So he has actually been the best friend to Christian America that he could possibly be. And that's why they're willing to forgive past sins. And they're not relevant to why they voted for him. And for you, I think really, Chris, honestly, to dredge up Cohen, who is a reprehensible character, who's somebody who taped a lot of people, at least according to the Wall Street Journal, including you, mm-hmm. surreptitiously, this is a man who really operated like a snake in many ways, including versus the president. And for us to make a big deal about his actions and to really reveal to the world what was already known, I think any reasonable person who voted for Donald Trump.
Well, let's unpack that real quick.
Did not think they were voting
here. I take your point, but even
if... Listen, I think that's completely true. The reason that a lot of the Christian right is willing to call this a mulligan and look the other way mm-hmm. when they weren't willing to do
Graham.
The same for a Bill Clinton mm-hmm. is because of a Gorsuch, because of a Kavanaugh,
True.
Because Donald Trump is shutting down the rights of LGBTQ because he doesn't
right.
support or does not recognize yes. Pride Month because he sides with the Baker instead of the LGBTQ.
What has he done to LGBTQ?
All of those things make those people happy. Oh, come on. What has he done to LGBTQ? First thing his administration did was curtail the rights of transgender students in public schools. He doesn't even recognize Pride Month, something that practically every administration has done for years since before Trump. And you know why he has to do it? Because he's on very thin ice. Number one, because he's full of flaws and full of sins and because, nobody thought we were voting for John the Baptist, but did you think you were going to vote for Hugh Hefner? But also because he knows he's a hypocrite. He's
right.
playing evangelical right. He's playing Republican.
No,
he's delivering on
sheep's clothing. He's delivering on policy.
He's delivering on what
tariffs.
They want. But they used to
tariffs, slobbering to Putin.
No, the promise to get rid of Roe v. Wade, the promise to do those value
right.
culture war issues that they care about. But Steve Cordes, know this. There's a big difference between giving them the policy positions they want and delivering what they used to say they needed, which was a man of character, a woman of character. And they used to define it differently than they do today. Steve Cordes, Anna Navarro, thank you both. Appreciate the debate.